Our next question comes from Mr. Smith of Salisbury, who writes, should a fire guard know his sector point as well as his assembly point? Joan?
Well, of course, it all depends on what you mean by a fire guard. It wouldn't apply, for instance, to the fire guard we put before the nursery fire.
Well, I remember many years ago we were lying off Zanzibar with a supercargo. Pretty inflammable stuff it was, too. One night, one of the packing cases caught fire. The cat happened to be asleep on top of it. Right overhead was the ship's bell, so the cat jumped up, hung on the bell rope, rang 8 bells, up came the dog watch and put the fire out. I'd say quite definitely that cat was a fire guard.
But surely we're getting away from the question. When a street party is tackling fires and fire guard reinforcements or the NFS are needed, the party leader will have to order a fire guard to run to this sector point with a message to the sector captain asking for this help. And of course, if he's a member of a party in a block, he ought to know, firstly, his assembly point, secondly, block point, and thirdly, his sector point. Again, because he may be sent there with messages asking for fire guard reinforcements or NFS help.
Well, limp with admiration at that magnificent exposition, I think we can sum up by saying that whereas a cat has 9 lives, you have only one. So you'd better make sure that you know your assembly point, your block point, and your sector point. Then if your party leader asks you to call for help, you'll know where to go to. We hope.